Testing. This is Devin. I am Writing Daily. That is the name of the podcast that I do every single day of every day. And so here we are. Welcome. Today we are going to focus on the mystery of actually writing daily. How do we do that? Because that's the whole point of the show. Yes, we talk about promotions and we talk about self-marketing. We talk about getting our work done. And I think one of the magic things is, how do we write daily? What's the impetus for it? What do we get? How do we get moving forward in that direction? And that's certainly one of the biggest pictures here, because if we're not putting words to the page, it really doesn't matter. If you are new, my name is Devin Gallaudet. I am the editor-in-chief for the last almost 14 years of In the Know Traveler. And I am also the author of the forthcoming memoir, 10,000 Miles with My Dead Father's Ashes. As always, feel free to fill in the little boxes. Please like and follow and do all that kind of fun stuff. It is most greatly appreciated. And let us know that we are working together to develop our wonderful writers community. Morgana, thank you very much for being here. Always appreciated. And so what are we talking about? We're talking about writing daily. That's the name of the show, because that's really the secret key from where all of our writing in terms of consistency comes from. So how do we do that? How do I do that? But first, before we get there, let me tell you a little story. So I met with my publisher and editorial director about 10 days ago. And one of the things that we talked about is that, like, okay, what other books are you working on? What's that look like? And so I have, like, actually several other titles that I'm working at current. I'm going to keep those under wraps, at least for the moment. But I had something. And so as he was saying, yeah, no, you need to have something, because you don't want to necessarily position yourself as somebody that nobody can find out anything about, and that you're working as a writer. So if somebody loves your book, they can already be working in the enthusiasm and the excitement about when your next title is coming out. So anyway, within a day, I sent actually my publisher some excerpts of what was happening with some other books, just so they could kind of get a taste of what I'm working on. And I think that's an important thing to do, because not only do I want the world at large to understand that I'm you know, working on more, but I also want the people who are help promoting me to be, like, have the confidence that there's going to be future publications coming out as well. So that said, I've been now doing writing daily for this is our 51st episode, and that's because I'm doing it every single day. So how did that happen? Well, okay, so probably the number one thing is, I have to acknowledge, is that I intended to start writing daily on January 1. I don't think I got started until something like February 15th. That's probably not the right date, but it's right around February 15th was when I actually started doing this work. And I've missed a couple days. I probably missed, I think, three total days. I think I caught up on one of them. Really, a couple of them were unavoidable. But I've been pretty solid, I would certainly say, for over a month now. And so what's the difference between the first, you know, few days, or the first, you know, whatever it is, 45 days of the year, and once I started? Well, there was a commitment. And even in the first few days where I missed a couple days, there still wasn't the measure of commitment. What I think has happened now is that I have developed a habit. In other words, when I wake up in the morning, I'm already thinking about, well, what is it that I'm going to be doing? What am I going to be talking about to the writers out in the world, right? What am I talking about? So I had to create a habit. And really, the number one way to create a habit is to make it a priority. I would say for that first week where I missed a day or so, comes from the fact that I was still like, yeah, I want to do this every single day, but will I? Will I do it every single day? And the answer was, well, I'm not really as committed or as focused as I should be. Because I've now been doing this every day, you know, for the most part now for, you know, again, our 51st episode, is that I have to focus on this is a priority. In other words, when I wake up in the morning, and it's happening organically, that I am planning on doing the show. Like, it's not, there hasn't been anything showing up that has been all that pressing. Like, as an example, today was tax day. So yesterday I spent, I would say, the vast majority of the day going through the bits and pieces of my life in terms of dollars and cents, and I put everything in order. But even though I spent pretty much the entire day doing that, I already had a show in mind and I stopped what I was doing, more important than my taxes, to make sure that I'm talking with you guys. So today I actually went and saw my accountant and I sat in his office. And then, what do you think I make this a priority of? I show up here and I do the best that I can. Okay, and Morgana writes, what's your next book, Devin? You know, honestly, there is one of three titles. One has to do with a series of short stories. Hi, Veronica, welcome. One is a series of short stories that I've been working on probably for about 10 years, and I probably have about 60,000 words in that. Those are fiction. I have probably about 40,000 words on the relationship with my mother. I'm sure she'll be thrilled to know that that's in the work, especially after she reads the book about Dad. And then I have one that's based upon the relationship or the weddings that I have. For those who don't know, my wife and I are in the process of getting married 100 times in 100 countries, 20 weddings so far. It's very exciting. Hey, Veronica. So anyway, the point is that as a writer, I have things in the hopper, and that's my point. However, the admission I have is that since I've been doing this podcast every single day, I haven't been doing it the way that I should be. In other words, the way that I should be is I do the podcast, but I should be coupling it with the actual work of writing. Now, I've done some writing, but I haven't put my money where my mouth is. Like, when I was working on 10,000 Miles, I was writing daily. I was doing the work every day. And the podcast, this theme is that we should be doing the work every single day, even if it's for 5 minutes. Set an egg timer. Set your super phone watch. Like, I guarantee you it has a million buzzers on it. So if you want to write for 5 minutes and then have and get notified, you can totally do that. But my recommendation is, which I haven't followed, that I'm going to, and I'm going to start letting you know my honest progress, is that right now I have to focus on a daily work. That means that it may be 5 or 10 minutes. It also may be an hour, because I think it's really important. And by the way, if you like what I'm saying, please consider hitting the like button or the love button or the wow button, so I know that we are running along the right course. So I also have, just so you know, we're going to be having this conversation with some other writers. I've been speaking with a handful of writers. Matter of fact, if you guys remember last week, I was talking about a writer, Adrian Zuniga. I still don't know if I have his pronunciation right. And we're going to talk about his story probably in the upcoming weeks. He was out of the country, and now I think he's back in. And so we're going to do that. But I guess the goal here is, and I'm going to throw this out as a challenge to you, that if you're watching this video and you're saying to yourself, oh, I should be writing every single day, then it's time to start developing the habit. Scientifically speaking, at least according to the books that I've read, is that I'm going to answer this question in a second, Veronica, is that what I have read is that there is somewhere between 25 and like 105 days where if you keep doing the same thing, you can develop a habit that you can last for the rest of your life. Of course, you have to set aside time to do it. Veronica writes, is there a ritual you have to prepare? Honestly, there's a million different ways to kind of prepare and ritualize it. And basically, what a ritual is, the way I look at it, is that you're setting apart a particular action and you're making it sacred. It's something that you do that enhances everything else. So for writing, it just could be that when my alarm goes off at 1 o'clock, when I typically try to do this show, the next goal will be, I'm going to sit down and write for 20 minutes, period. And nothing is I'm turning off my phone, I'm turning off the computer, or not the computer because I write on the computer, but I'm going to spend 20 minutes of my time spitting out something. It doesn't have to be great work. It doesn't have to be the best work. It doesn't have to be polished and beautiful work. What it has to do is move the ball forward some tiny thing. Now, if you want to meditate for a couple minutes, then do that. If you want to make a more elaborate ritual because you're somebody who loves ceremony, there's all kinds of things you can do with that. Those are funny, but I would keep them short so you can spend your time really getting down to what the real work is, which is writing. So let's see, 1 p.m. means kick your wife out of the gray room. Yeah, no, actually it totally does. And that's something that I did today. I'm sure my wife has zero issues with that. So anyway, if you like what I'm doing, we are writing daily. We're talking about writing. We're getting other writers to give their insights to how they do it. And we're hopefully here to get more writing done, better writing accomplished, more efficient done, things done, and sending your book and your short stories out into the universe to be published and be witnessed and marveled by all. So as always, please consider hitting this like button or asking me a question, and I will get to everything, I promise. And if I love your question, we may do a whole episode on it. Honestly, going back to Veronica, is there a ritual? I may do a larger podcast just on doing ritual in terms of developing your stamina and creating a sacredness around your writing, because that's what it is. It's a marvelous thing. Those of us who do creative writing, we are calling something down that I don't know where it comes from. I don't think it originates with me. I think I'm just acting as a conduit. But that all said, please come back next week. As always, feel free to join me at devingalladay.com/dad, where you can see a little bit more about 10,000 Miles, as well as my query that got sold. That query helped me get sold. More about it from episode number 50. And so that's what we've got today. Thank you so much for joining us, and I will talk to you guys again real soon.